On 25th of July this month, elections took place in Pakistan. Now, the entire world is aware of the massive levels of rigging that took place in the election. As most of the observers have mentioned in their reports after the election, the whole election campaign, or in other words, the run-up to the election, was not free, fair and transparent by any means. As we all know, Pakistani military establishment gave special preferential treatment to Mr. Imran Khan and his political party Tehreek-e-Insaf or PTI. All the political rivals of Mr. Imran Khan, they were marginalized. In case of Mr. Nawaz Sharif, his party faced a number of allegations from Pakistani judiciary and Pakistan's accountability body, which is called NAB. And Mr. Nawaz Sharif was actually forced to resign or leave the position of prime ministership. And then a few days before the election, he was arrested along with his daughter, Maryam Nawaz Sharif. The people who were running on the ticket of Pakistan Muslim League, they were forced to either quit their election campaign or join Tehreek-e-Insaf. In Urban Sindh, the mainstream political party of the Urban Sindh or Muhajirs, MKM was marginalized not just in the last few months, but actually right from the day when the last election took place. MKM had to face a crackdown in the last 5 years. It was forced to be fragmented into many factions, and even as of today, its head office is still sealed, and thousands of MKM members are still either in hiding or in prison, or they have gone missing. The similar complaints have also been received from the rest of the country, where a number of political parties have been forced to stop their campaigning, or they have been prevented from campaigning through intimidation or through false cases and charges. A candidate of Awami National Party was even killed in the run-up to the election. And the same happened in Balochistan. And on the day of election, as we all know, Pakistani people came out in large number in all the areas of Pakistan, but stayed home in Karachi as a mark to register their protest against the excessive practices of Pakistani military establishment. And we saw a very low turnout in Karachi. But at the same time, we know that people still voted for other political parties than PTI, and then the personnel of law enforcement agencies occupied polling stations, forced the polling agents of other political parties, and then in the morning we all see that PTI won with a huge majority. Excuse me. What is surprising that some of the candidates in Karachi who until a couple of years ago had failed to secure victory in local bodies constituency, they won National Assembly elections by a big margin. So it is apparent that the elections were rigged, and it is also apparent that millions of people, not just a few hundred thousand, millions of Pakistani voters have been disenfranchised through intimidation, through illegal and undemocratic actions of Pakistani military establishment. I believe there should be no doubt in the minds of any rational person that the elections were a fraud. They were just a sham, and the establishment had already chosen Mr. Imran Khan as its favored chosen candidate to become Prime Minister of Pakistan. This is just the mockery of people's mandate. And it has severely affected the democratic process in Pakistan. And I request international community to consider these elections very carefully, and if possible, demand re-election in Pakistan under the supervision of the United Nations. So people of Pakistan deserve and demand a free, fair, transparent election, not a rigged election as we witnessed on 25th of July. Thank you very much.